Yeah, we're good. Welcome to the Hawk Sports Network. You're watching OCAA men's baseball as your Humber Hawks face off against the Durham Lords. I'm Kyle Dalton. I'm joined by Andrew Milani. The Hawks come into the game winners of five straight and look to take the season series from the Lords. We're here in the second inning. Both teams going 1-2-3. Now you can see Rory Pollard on the mound for the Hawks. Now, Andrew, what do you think of his last performance and what he can do tonight?
Last performance, he was great going full game. And he hasn't allowed an earned run all season. He could definitely do some great work tonight.
Yeah, this Durham lineup, 6-6 on the season, haven't won a series this year, splitting every single game they've played when they've gone somewhere. As you can see here, we'll bring up Sam Cocker, catcher on the team. Durham Lords going 1-2-3 in the top half of the inning. The ground ball to short. Gonzalez, strong throw to Lyons, one away.
Nice routine play by Gonzalez.
Yeah, Gonzalez really wanted the rock on that defense. First year player on the team. The Hawks also go in 1-2-3 in their bottom half of the inning. There's a strike one. The Hawks have scored the most run in the league with 99, and have given up the second fewest so far with 36.
They've been dominant all season.
There's a strikeout there by Pollard on Regan Manley, two away. I'll bring up Max Mockin, third baseman for the team. Talked about Durham coming into this game, 6-6 on the season. They've won five of the first game doubleheaders, so they usually get off to a good start to start off the series.
Just not able to finish it up.
Well, the last time against Humber, they took the first game in Durham and had a comfortable lead going into the seventh. And the Hawks able to score three runs to win that game 8-6. Ball just down on that curveball there. Martin comes over to play it. Strong throw to Lyons off the bag with the tag of Malkin. And another 1-2-3 inning for Rory Pollard as we head to the bottom of the second.
Great play to stay with the base runner and make the out.
Yeah, Ty Martin coming over to cut off Gonzalez. Makes a strong throw a bit off the bag, but Lyons with the tag on Malkin. Another 1-2-3 inning for Rory Pollard. He's really been solid so far this season. Alec Brown on the mound for the Lords. He's pitched outstanding so far this season, only giving up an ERA of 0.67. The 3-0 record.
Impressive 18 strikeouts in 21 innings as well coming into this game.
Should be a good pitching matchup here with Brown and Pollard. So far, all innings so far have gone 1-2-3. DeBannon will look to change that here. First pitch comes in a bit low. ground ball foul there on the right side. Humber coming in this game 6 points ahead of St. Clair with 4 points here. With two wins, they can clinch first place heading into the postseason. Bit inside there. Counts 1-1. Ball's hit foul. DeBanning out in front on the brown fastball. Count goes to 3-2.
DeBanning has been one of the Humber's better hitters all season with a 370 average coming into this game and leads the team with 20 RBIs.
And he'll start off at the bottom of the second with a leadoff single up the middle. Talked about his consistency and a show in there. Leadoff single. I'll bring up Keegan Murphy.
Great job making contact, finding a gap in the center of the infield.
Staying with that ball, hitting where it came from.
Next at bat is Keegan Murphy.
Hawks look to get something going early here against Brown. Talked about DeBanning. He's in his third season with the Hawks. See the earlier move there from Brown. DeBanning reading that well, going back.
DeBanning already has a couple stolen bases this season, so he's definitely a threat to steal.
Up and in there. See if Matt Ferreira thinks the same thing as you, trying to get DeBanning going here early.
Might not be a bad idea to be aggressive, try and get the lead early on.
Comes the 1-0 pitch. Just on the outside corner, strike one. Hawks coming into this game, winners of 5 straight. Looking to continue their streak. They'll finish the season next Friday against George Brown and on that Saturday versus Seneca. So good test here against the Lords, who they've struggled with so far a bit this season, losing that first game back in Durham. In the second game, we're behind for most of the game until coming back in that seventh inning to win an 8-6. Be a good test here tonight. Murphy showing bunt here, fouls it off. Back to first, double play. 4-6-3 double play for the Lords. Gets Brown out of that small jam. To start the inning of the leadoff single by DeBanning is erased. Two outs here. I'll bring up Hunter Bisser.
Next at bat is Hunter Bisser.
Strike one there at the knees. Hunter Bisser trying to start something here. Brown gets ahead early here. 0-2, look like a changeup. Bisser a bit out in front. Second base. Brian Woke, second baseman with the play. Strong throw over to Jake LeGros.
Another strong inning by Alec Brown.
Yeah, gave up an early single, leadoff single to DeBanning, but got that ground ball double play, and then gets Hunter Bisser to ground out to second base down the inning. Andrew, the Hawks come into this game winners of five straight. What do you think they need to do to keep that streak going here against the Lords?
Well, they'll definitely want to get some hits early on, put some pressure on the other team, and especially Alec Brown early on, get him out of his comfort zone.
That's a good point. You don't want Alec Brown to get going, especially when he gets into a rhythm. He's tough to beat. The Hawks really want to put some pressure on. They had that good start with DeBanning with the leadoff single, but that double play really killed the momentum. There, they'll see if they can get something going in the bottom of the third. For now, Rory Pollard back on the mound here to begin the third inning.
And to that same note, you don't want to give Durham anything early on.
Yep. Rory Pollard has been outstanding so far this season. First time he's pitched against Durham this season. Durham, in the first game, they saw Stephen Huff and Brendan Lyons in that doubleheader matchup back in Durham early on in the year. We'll see who the Hawks decide to throw in game two, but for now it's Rory Pollard in game one. This will bring up Connor June, center fielder on the team, batting seventh.
That is Connor Bain.
Showing bunt here is May. Count goes to 1-1. Check swing down first, no swing. Rory Pollard's last time out versus Fanshawe. You mentioned earlier when he went seven innings, giving up three hits, no runs, five strikeouts on the outing as well. There's a base hit for May up the middle. First hit for the Lords to begin the game.
Great patience showed by May early on in that at bat. Just waited for his pitch. Got a single.
One of the key things for the Lords is to get that bottom of the lineup working. Really sets the tone for that top of the lineup coming back. Brian Woke, Brandon Datsun. You really want the bottom line to be on base when those hitters are up. See if Aiden Ali can keep it going here as the DH for tonight's game. Ground ball foul. Right in the inside corner, strike one. Throw over nine time, May only one stolen base on the season. See if Coach Sam Depster decides to get something going here in his 27th season with the team.
Absolutely incredible.
He's been the leader for the Durham Lords for 27 seasons now. Looking to keep it going here. Curveball just on the inside corner. Throw down, not in time. Counts 2-2. to the eight hitter, Aiden Ali. Leadoff single by Connor May. Just down there. Counts 3-2. Fouled off there.
He keeps himself alive with that foul ball.
Aiden Ali in his second season from Whitby, Ontario. Throw over, not in time to get May. Pollard thinking maybe something happening here with a 3-2 count.
Not taking any chances with that runner on first base.
Not running as May. It'll be ball four. A little bit something brewing here for the Lords with their 9-hitter up the plate with runs on first and second. Be McIntosh. Could possibly see a bunt here scenario with the leadoff hitter Brian Woke on deck. Shows bunt. Lines looking to third, back to first. In time to get McIntosh.
That was a great bunt by McIntosh, right where you want to put it, between the pitcher and the catcher.
Line
against the runners.
Yeah, line looked over to third to Ty Martin, realizing he wasn't going to have a play there, threw it to first. Keegan Murphy covering, get the sure out. Now the Hawks defense will come in here trying to get Connor May at the plate. Brian Woke, leadoff hitter for the Lords. He struck out in his first at bat in the first inning to lead off the game. Pollard still hasn't given up a run this season. That's in jeopardy here. Looking to get something on the ground.
Two runners in scoring position right now. Any ball to the outfield could score both runs.
Mara faking over to the third. Again, the runner back diving. Count moves to 2-1 here. Curveball bounces away. Not a solid read there by Connor May. Doesn't allow him to score. The ball got away from Mara there. Lucky break for the Hawks. Connor May didn't read that well. It's another break here for the Hawks. Counts 3-1.
Could have easily been the first earned run allowed by Pollard this season.
On the ground, ball's gonna bounce foul. Bring the count to 3-2. Brian Woke hitting 320 on the season. Not a big power guy.
Only 3 RBIs on the season for him.
Ball's driven to left field. That's drifting foul.
Maybe a little too eager to get those runs in.
Yeah, for him, it's just trying to find something on the ground here. Get something in the air. Could score at least one. Check swing, no swing. And that'll load the bases as well as the pitching meeting here.
Now batting. Bases loaded with only one out. Pollard in serious jeopardy of allowing his first earned run of the season.
Assistant coach Jeff Gibbs will come out to have a word with Pollard and Mara. Just to settle him down a little. Hasn't really given up any hard hit balls. two walks in the inning. Now an opportunity for Brendan Dotson to put some damage on the board here for the Lords.
It's important.
Sorry, go ahead.
I was just going to say it's important for Pollard here to just make his pitch, get some strikes, and get ahead early on in the count.
That's a great point. You don't want to fall behind here on Dotson, especially with the bases loaded. Want to get into his count. First pitch just inside.
That's what he's got to keep doing.
Attacking that inside part of the plate. Don't allow those Lords hitters to get comfortable. Good fastball on the outside part of the plate. Pollard's got to think he's one pitch away, get a ground ball, let his infield turn that double play. Curveball gets away, 2-1.
Do you guys want like a hot coffee or anything like that?
Can I have a coffee, please?
Throw over, not in time. Hummer bench thought they got him. Strong throw by Mara. Ty Martin with the solid tag. Right, he's counted 2-2 now. Roy Pollard really wants to get Dats on this pitch. Don't let the count go to 3-2. Gonzalez on the ground.
Double play ball.
Murphy, the throw not in time to get Dats in. A run will score, which is Connor May. The leadoff single came around to score for the Lords. The Lords lead 1-0.
Dotson, one of the best hitters for the Lords this season. Just getting contact, bringing in that run.
And the Lords getting to Pollard early here with a score of 1-0. It's those two walks that really kill Pollard. So bring up Jake LeGros. Ball's fouled off.
LeGros sporting an impressive 412 batting average coming into this game. So he could definitely hit the ball.
LeGros in his third season with the Lords. Lords with 12 rookies on the team this season. There's on the ground to Ty Martin. Strong throw to lines over to first to get LeGros to end the top half of the third inning. Pollard got in some trouble, really didn't command his fastball that well in the third inning, missing a bid, two walks. That leadoff single came around to score by Connor May. But we'll see if he can settle down back in the fourth as we head into the bottom of the third here. And the Hawks will have 7-8-9, Ty Martin leading off.
Ty Martin
leading off the bottom of the third. Alec Brown, the starting pitcher for the Durham Lords, pitched in the first game in Durham in the first series they had against each other. He went 7 innings, giving up 4 hits with only 1 run on 6 strikeouts. So he's very solid for them. looked into doing the same here. Hawks looking to have a little better performance at the plate against Alec Brown. Big cut there by Martin.
Martin, second-year player from Acton, Ontario. One of the better players on this Humber team. One of 11 players, actually, with a 300 batting average.
Big cut there by Martin. Count goes to 1-2. Alec Brown getting ahead of these Hawks hitters so far in this game. There's that slider cutting through the body of Martin. Great pitch.
Excellent pitch to strike him out.
Caught Martin looking there. Slider cut in. Looked like from batter's perspective, looked like it's coming right at you, then cuts right down the middle.
No chance on that.
Easy call for the umpire. And I'll bring up the shortstop, Gonzalez. Gonzalez in his first team, first year on the team. Really known for his defense. Just down there. Here comes the 1-1 from Brown. On the ground, Brian Woak with a nice play over to LeGros at first. For the second out of this inning, saw a play by Woak going across his body.
Tougher than it looks.
Next to that is Andrew Thompson.
They'll bring up Andrew Thompson, fifth year player, playing right field, batting .900 in this game. Liam Sutherland on deck for the Hawks. Just up there. So far, Alec Brown has pitched very solid against the Hawks, only giving up one hit through the first eight hitters. Has two Ks to go along with that. There's Thompson showing bunt. Pulls it back for ball one. Or two, excuse me, two balls. No strikes. Big swing by Thompson, the 2-0 count. Looking to find a gap here. Get Sutherland at the plate. Big swing there by Sutherland. Looks like he dropped his thumb guard. Alec Brown doing a good job battling back here, falling behind 2-0 quickly to Thompson, now 2-2. There's that slider from Brown, another strikeout, this time of Thompson, as we head to the top of the fourth. So far, it's been all Lords, 1-0 here. Hawks looking for their first run of the game.
Alec Brown has certainly lived up to his billing, has been impressive so far all game. Three strikeouts, that brings his grand total to 21 for the season.
The end of three innings here. The Durham Lords lead 1-0. Humber Hawks women's softball team continue their homestand tomorrow with a doubleheader against the Durham Lords. The game will be at 1 and 3, and you can watch it right here on the Hawks Sports Network. Ori Pollard back out to begin the fourth inning, and he saw his streak of not giving up any runs so far this season come to an end.
Can't let that get to him, though. He's got to stick to the game plan, continue to make strikes and get ahead of the count.
That's a good point. He's got to forget about that run. I'm sure he wasn't thinking about the streak coming into this game. Just looking to make some good pitches. There's a bit high for ball one.
Got to have a short memory in sports.
This will be Sam Cocker, catcher for the Lords in the first game. Ball's fouled off. Cocker hitting 346 on the season. Ball's popped up.
Looks playable.
Murphy under that one makes the grab for the first out.
Next to bat is Reagan Manley.
That's what Pollard's got to do.
This will bring up Reagan Manley. He struck out in the second inning in his first at bat. The five hitter in this Lords lineup. First pitch curveball down and in for ball one.
Already has six stolen bases on the season, so he's someone you definitely don't want to get on base.
See if Rory can keep him off here. See Ty Martin playing right on the grass. Ball's fouled off. Counts 1-2 now. On the ground to Murphy. Over to Lyons for the second out. Easy play for Murphy. I'll bring up Max Machen.
Next at bat is Max Mokon.
The strike there by Pollard to get ahead of the Lords' third baseman. Pitch right in the outside corner. Pollard getting ahead quick, 0-2 here. Getting the first two batters quickly. Now up 0-2. Curveball once again to Murphy. And another strong throw over Lyons. Another 1-2-3 inning for Pollard. Good bounce back from that top of the third.
That could be tough for a pitcher, knowing you have a streak coming in, then dealing with that after, just not letting it rattle you. It's tough.
Yeah, it was a great job by Pollard. After that top of the third, he kind of get his control wasn't there. Had a few walks in the inning, but came back in the top of the fourth with 1-2-3 batters. Really getting Cocker to pop up to Murphy, and then two straight ground balls to Murphy to end the inning as we head to the bottom of the fourth. And the Hawks look to get on the board here and try to tie this game. They'll have the top of the lineup with Sutherland up. Sutherland will lead off for the Hawks here against Brown. The Hawks look to get something going here. Try to get their 2017 OCAA Player of the Year on base here to begin in the bottom of the fourth. There's a a ground ball to short. Retired there is Sutherland. LeGros with the put out at first. Strong play there by Brendan Datsun at short for the Lords. I'll bring up Justin Mara, who struck out in his first at bat.
Next at bat, Justin Mara.
Mara hitting 389 on the season for the Hawks. Strike one on the outside corner. Just outside there. Brown's trying to stay away from Mara. Stay away from that power. That's fouled off there by Mara. Count goes to 1-2. Mara gets strikes out there, his second strikeout of the game. That'll be Brown's fourth, as there's two out here for the three hitter on the Hawks, Brendan Lyons. Strike one at the knees on Lyons. Lyons flew out to the center field during his first at bat. That ball's ripped off the mound. Over to first. LeGros can't scoop it. The ball gets away, but Lyons will hold up at first. And it'll be an error on the shortstop, Brendan Datsun. The ball skipped off the mound there. Datsun trying to hurry up the throw. Overthrows LeGros, and Lyons will reach on the air.
Let's see if the Hawks could take advantage of that error.
See if this two-out error comes around to bite the Lion or the Lords. DeBanning, that's driven to right field. And the right fielder, McIntosh, gets on that one to end the inning as we head to the top of the fifth. Alec Brown continuing his dominance of the Hawks. It's still 1-0 here as we head to the top of the fifth. Here's Connor May. He led off the third and eventually came around to score. The only run so far for the Lords. It's a ground ball to first, just foul. Roy Pollard with three strikeouts on the day so far. That ball is hit to right field, and that's going to bounce in front of Thomas for another leadoff single for Connor May. Connor May leads off the top of the fifth with a single. This will bring up Aiden Ali, the designated hitter for game one of this game. He walked his last at bat. That ball's hit to right center. Sutherland under that one. He'll make the grab. One away here. Connor May retreats to first. How important do you think it is for Rory to get these bottom of the lineup hitters out before that top of the lineup comes up?
Oh, it's very important. You don't want your bottom of the lineup guys on base when the top of the lineup comes up, when they can bring them in. Double play ball here.
And a good strong play beginning with Murphy and Gonzalez to Lyons to get Pollard out of the inning. Like you said, you don't want that top of the lineup to come up with runners on base. And McIntosh grounds into the inning-ending double play, and that means the Lords' top lineup will come up with nobody on to begin the sixth. A good strong 4-6-3 double play for the Hawks. Be Keegan Murphy leading off for the Hawks here against Alec Brown. There's only been three hits so far in this game. Two by the Lords, only one by the Hawks, which was DeBanning back in the second inning. So far it's been a pitcher's duel. You would think for Alec Brown, one run might be all he needs.
Could be.
It's up and in there for ball one. See if the Hawks can get something going here against Alec Brown. Brown quieting the bats of the Hawks hitter so far. That ball's fouled off. Ball's up and away, 2-1 now. Keegan Murphy trying to get on base here for the Hawks to lead off the bottom of the fifth. Try to get something going here.
Definitely want to get something going here. Don't want to have to wait till the last inning.
Ball's fair down the right left field line. Murphy's making a turnaround first. He's headed for second. Here comes the throw. Safe, and they're saying he's under the tag. As Murphy with the leadoff double to start it off for the Hawks. The throw from McIntosh, strong throw. Brian Woke with the tag at second. Umpire saying he went right around it. That allows Murphy with the leadoff double.
Great job by Keegan Murphy to pull that ball along the foul line and then come up with the perfect slide to get himself safe into second base.
That throw definitely beat him by McIntosh. Like you said, Murphy doing a good job getting around that tag. That gives the Hawks a leadoff double.
I thought he was going to be out. Impressive slide.
Had the ball. Definitely beat him for sure. Like we keep saying, a good slide there by Murphy. Now the Hawks here have an opportunity to try to at least tie this game with Hunter Bisser at the plate. Showing bunt here, pulls it back. See if head coach Matt Ferreira for the Hawks keeps that bunt on. Ty Martin is on deck, followed by Gonzalez. Not showing bunt here, that ball goes down the dirt. The good hitters count now for Bisser, up 2-0 here.
Brown now falling behind 3-0. Looks to have lost control of that strike zone.
Brown down 3-0, like you said. See if he can battle back here. That one goes up. It'll be ball four to Hunter Bisser. Not much damage there for Brown, as he will now have the force out at each base right now. It looks like Ty Martin will be pinch hit here. Looks like Cameron Wilcox will be the next batter for the Hawks. Cameron Wilcox.
Correction, now at bat is number 29, Cam Wilcox.
Has one hit on the year with only two at bats. That one hit was a double. An opportunity now for Wilcox to possibly drive in some runs. We'll see if he puts down the bunt here. See what Coach Ferrer decides. No bunt shown. He takes strike one. On deck is Gonzalez, followed by Thompson, the nine hitter, and then back to the top. That ball's hit down the right side. Base hit. Murphy's getting held at third. And Wilcox comes up big with a base hit. Now it's the bases loaded for Gonzalez.
This is definitely a big situation for the Hawks. No outs, bases loaded, down by one.
Jared Gonzalez.
The infield is playing in right now. Looking to cut the runner at the plate. Though it's only up 1-0 here. Still nobody out in the inning. That ball comes right inside. Ball one. Gonzalez grounded out to the second baseman, his first at bat. Foul tip there, strike one. Brown going from the full here on the mound. Looking for something on the ground. That ball's over the third base. That's a base hit.
That's going to score two.
Here comes Bisser around to score as well. And the Hawks take a 2-1 lead on the RBI single by Gonzalez.
Huge base hit.
The base hit that took a hop early. Bounced over the third baseman's head, Max Mokin. And no chance for the Lords to get Hunter Bisser at the plate. He comes around to score easily. And Murphy, which was at third base, he came around to score as well. And the Hawks lead 2-1 here in the bottom of the fifth. Still nobody out in the inning. Gonzalez, not really known for his hitting, mostly known for his defense at short. He comes up big for the Hawks with a two-run single and gives the Hawks the lead. Alec Brown struggling here in this inning. What do you think's been the problem for Alec Brown?
He just seems to have lost control of the strike zone. Can't seem to make strikes consistently.
Yeah, that seems to be the case.
Falling behind a lot in the count.
Yeah, the 3-0 counts, 2-0 counts. Those aren't cause for success if you're a pitcher. That'll bring up Andrew Thompson, who struck out to end the third inning in his first at-bat. He's an opportunity here. Thompson shows bunt. It's a solid bunt down the third base line. No chance for Moken to make a play. An excellent bunt there by Thompson. And another base hit for the Hawks. We talked about coming into this inning, the Hawks only had one hit, which is by DeBanning in the second inning. In this inning, they already have four, which has caused for two runs. Still nobody out in the inning.
And they've loaded the bases twice.
And this is when you want the bases loaded. We talked about the bottom of the lineup being a key contributor. Now that brings up Liam Sutherland, one of the best hitters on the team. Ball's just outside. Sutherland trying to put this game away here with a big base hit. Ball's outside, 2-0. Alec Brown, we don't usually see this from him. He seems to have a lot of control when he's pitching. Here in the fifth, he's lost all his control. Already a down 3-0 to Sutherland here with the bases loaded. The bullpen is working right now for the Lords. And Brown walks, the bases loaded. Sutherland will reach as Wilcox will come in to score, and the Hawks lead 3-1.
Very uncharacteristic inning for Alec Brown.
Yeah, you talked about his control, and to Liam Sutherland there, we get it. You don't want to give him good pitches to throw or to hit, but with the bases loaded.
Definitely don't want to walk a guy with the bases loaded.
You can't afford to walk anybody, and that's a huge blow for the Lords, and I'll bring up Justin Mara. Again, still nobody out in the inning. Mara fouls that one off. Gonzalez at third base, Thompson at second, and Sutherland at first. Mara at the plate here. 1-1 count. That ball's hit up the middle. Gonzalez is going to come in to score. And here comes Thompson to score to third base. Is Sutherland, he'll reach, and that allows Mara to move up to second. And the Hawks lead 5-1.
And this inning just looks like it's about to go on the verge of going out of control. Alec Brown looked like he was in the zone coming into this inning, then all of a sudden couldn't find the strike zone. And when he has found the strike zone, it seems it's been gone for a hit.
Yeah, you have to think that third time through the lineup for the Hawks really got to Alec Brown. And it's showing here, Mara with a base hit, a two-run single. He moves up to second on the throw. Lyons watches that one go by for strike one. And the Hawks, still nobody out in this inning with the banning on deck. Big swing for Lyons there. Caught out in front. Now he's down 0-2. That ball's over. Lyons, as Sutherland will come in to score. Alec Brown waving his hand to Lyons, saying, "My bad." That ball just missed his head. Sutherland comes in to score on the wild pitch.
Great heads-up play by Sutherland. Mara didn't stop at all, just went straight for home plate.
Yep. Mara moves up to third on that wild pitch. Counts 1-2 now to Lyons. That ball's driven to right field. Mara tagging. McIntosh gets under it with a throw wide, and Mara will score. Lyons with the sacrifice fly, and the Hawks lead 7-1. Coming into this inning, we talked about Alec Brown and how consistent and how dominant he has been coming into this game and even in this game. And so far, he's given up 7 runs here in the bottom of the fifth. Just things have really unraveled for him.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. Maybe the Hawks found something in his pitching or something, but he's just lost control.
That ball grounded to second baseman Awoke. Over to first for the out. That's two away. But yeah, maybe the control, maybe some the Hawks found something like you mentioned. But just you don't really see that a lot from Brown. The Hawks putting up a big seventh spot here in the bottom of the fifth. I'll bring up Keegan Murphy. He started off this inning with a double. Now he's back to the plate here. The Hawks have batted around. Ball in the inside corner for strike one. Big swing there by Murphy. Lord's bullpen with two pitchers warming up. This could be the end of the line for Brown after the fifth. That ball's driven to left field. Looking back, this one is gone. Keegan Murphy, a two-out home run. A no doubter over the fence, and the Hawks lead 8-1.
Just when it looked like Alec Brown had regained his control, he allows a home run, and this inning continues.
It looks like that's going to be it for Alec Brown. That was a monster shot from Keegan Murphy. He started off this inning with a double and he continues his rake in this inning with a solo home run with two outs. And the Hawks lead now 8-1. They have a new pitcher on the mound for the Lords. Still trying to figure out who the pitcher on the mound is for the Lords. As soon as we get it, we'll let you know. But for Alec Brown, it seemed that things really unraveled for him this inning. He was dominant through the first four innings. And it looked like he was going to go the full way once again against the Hawks like he did in the first meeting against each other. And things really unraveled for him here in the fifth.
Unraveled really quickly. Just fell apart all of a sudden.
And it was that bottom of the lineup really for the Hawks that really got it. Gonzalez with a big two-run double, followed by Thompson with a base hit. Wilcox coming off the bench with the base hit. So it's really those key contributors for the Hawks that really make the difference.
That's what you need. Your top guys have to perform, but at the end of the day, it's a team game. Everyone's got to come through.
Here's Hunter Bisser. He's 0-1 on the day with a walk in this inning. He eventually came around to score. Watches that one go by for strike one. Counts 1-1. Ball's down in the dirt. Counts 3-1. Good count here for Bisser. Hitter's count. Ball's way outside for ball four. And for Keegan Murphy, that was his first home run of the season. The Hawks fifth as a team.
Now at bat is Cam Wilcox.
Cam Wilcox back to the plate. He pinched hit for Ty Martin. Wilcox singled in this inning as well. Pitcher for the Lords is Josh Kirstolovich on the mound right now. There goes Bisser.
He'll get into second easily.
The catcher, Sam Cocker, bobbled the ball, allowed Bisser to get in there with no throw. Looking to get something going here with two outs. Looking to add to this 7-run lead. Ball down and away. Good spot there by Kirstolovich. 1-2. Big swing on the curveball. Kirstolovich comes in. Gives up a walk to Bisser, but strikes out Wilcox. As we head to the top of the sixth, the Hawks with a controllable lead here, up 8-1. Here at Connerville Park, sun is setting here on game one of this doubleheader. Doubleheader is scheduled for 8, or just after 8. Right now, it looks like the Hawks are in full control here, up 8-1 in the top of the sixth. They'll bring up the leadoff hitter, Brian Woke. Big swing there by Woke. Will go for one in the day with a strikeout. He also walked in the third inning. Watch that one go by for strike two.
And at this point for the Lords, you're just looking for something. Get on base, walk, anything. Something to try and cut down this giant lead.
That's a good point, I think, for the Lords as well, is if you can get something going maybe in this inning or even in the next, it gives you a little bit of momentum going into game two.
Absolutely.
Big curveball there by Pollard, fouled off.
Last thing you want is to feel bad about yourselves at the end of the game going into the second game of a doubleheader.
And the Lords seem to bounce back very nicely when they get a loss. Oh, Pollard thought that was a strike. Just low, says home plate umpire. Count goes to 1-2. That ball looks like it's drifting out. Lions might have a chance. Makes the grab right at the fence for the first out of this inning. Lions staying with that ball nicely. Good communication by Mara, letting him know how much space he has left. Lions able to make that grab. I'll bring up Brendan Dotson. It's a ground ball. Murphy with a nice play. Over to Lyons. Two away here. I'll bring up Jake LeGros. He's 0 for 2 on the day with a couple ground outs.
Nice at bat, Jake LeGros.
That ball's fouled off. LeGros behind on that Pollard fastball. Big cut there by LeGros. Pollard up quickly, 0-2 to the number 3 hitter. Up and in there, could be a set pitch. Could see that curveball coming from Pollard, working quickly here to LeGros. There's that curveball. Good take by LeGros. Strike three right at the knees. Catches LeGros looking. And Pollard settling down here. Another 1-2-3 inning. As the Hawks lead 8-1 as we head to the bottom of the sixth. And Andrew, what do you think of Pollard's performance so far today?
He's been great tonight. Just that little hiccup back there. But other than that, he's been fantastic. A lot of 1-2-3 innings. Attacking the strike zone. It's been great.
Yeah, he's been solid so far. It was that third inning where he really got into trouble. Lord's able to get one in that inning. And it allowed the Hawks to get back in this game, putting up an 8 spot in the fifth. But like you said, since then he's really settled down, become the pitcher that he's known for. As we head to the bottom of the sixth, the Hawks look to add on to their 8-1 lead.
It looks like Krstulovich is going to step back out there on the pitcher's mound for the Lords.
Yeah, the Lords had somebody else warming up as well. Coach Dempster allowing to stick with Krstulovich, who walked Bisser in his first at-bat, but then struck out Wilcox. Will bring up Gonzalez. He's 1 for 2 on the day. He had a two-run single in that big fifth inning for the Hawks. Had that ball bounce over the third baseman's head for that single.
Now at bat is Jared Gonzalez.
Look to get things going here for the Hawks. Up and in there to Gonzalez. That ball's ripped down left field, drifting foul. Gonzalez way out in front of that Krstulovich fastball. Count goes to 2-1. Gonzalez pops that up. Second baseman Woke makes the grab for the first out.
Now batting, Andrew Thompson.
So bring up Thompson. He singled last inning and came around to score. This ball's ripped. The left field gap, this one looks like it's going to drop. Ball's cut off by the center fielder, and Thompson will get into second with no throw and a one-out double for the number nine hitter. That's a good piece of hitting there by Thompson.
Absolutely. Was just able to walk into second base.
Really stayed with that outside pitch. Drove it into the gap. Leadoff double for Thompson. It'll bring up the top of the order and Liam Sutherland. Watches that one at the knees for strike one. The lights are starting to turn on here at Connerville Park. There's Thompson faking a run at second, trying to get that third baseman moving. Ball's fouled off. Sutherland with a big hack. 1-2 now. Ball's in the dirt, a curveball there. Catcher Cocker able to stay with that one. Count moves to 2-2. Opportunity here for 2017 OCAA Player of the Year. Get something going here for the Hawks. That ball's fouled off to the right side. There goes Thompson, that ball back to the pitcher. Over to first base. LeGros with the grab at first. Thompson was running on that pitch. Looked like a hit and run play. Thompson reaching at third, and that'll bring up Mara. A little bit of aggressiveness there from head coach Matt Ferreira, getting Thompson on the move.
Absolutely, not bad risk to take when you're up by seven runs.
It's a good count, two to run, one away. Two-way now here for Mara. Mara with two RBIs on the day. Had a two-run single in the fifth. That ball's driven to right field. Going back. Ball hangs up. The wind bringing that one back. Mara's retired, and that ends the bottom of the sixth as we head to the top of the seventh. It looks like Rory Pollard is going to come back out here to try to finish this one out. That ball looked like it had a chance to go and the wind just died out.
I thought it was going to go after it left the bat, but you're right, this wind with that, no chance of leaving the yard.
Yeah, the wind blowing in there. Tough for Mara to get that one over the fence. As we are through six innings here, the Hawks with a big 8-1 lead over the Lords here in game one of this doubleheader at Carnival Park.
Stickers for Elise.
The men's baseball team next game will be Friday, October 5th against George Brown. It'll be a doubleheader matchup at beginning at 5 o'clock. You can watch it here on the Hawk Sports Network. The Hawks baseball team will also be in action that Saturday to finish off the regular season against Seneca.
So important for them to finish off the regular season strong going into the OCAA championships hosted by Durham. Then eventually Humber will be hosting the national baseball championship.
And they hope to be playing in that national championship. Here's Sam Cocker, the catcher. He's 0 for 2 on the day. Watches that first pitch go by. Pollard with a curveball there. 0 and 2. Ball spiked in the dirt by Pollard. Count goes to 1 and 2.
Looked like a purpose pitch, maybe wanting him to swing at a low one.
Gets him on that. Looked like a changeup there by Pollard. Getting Cocker that way out in front.
Cocker clearly frustrated by that pitch.
Pollard has been outstanding so far in this game. Had a little bit of a slip up in the third inning where he gave up that run. And there's a base hit there. Regan Manley coming around to first. That's in the gap. He's head for second. Sutherland on that one throws it in and cuts Manley at second base. It'll be a one-out double, the third hit of the game for the Lords. Good piece of hitting, staying on that one and driving it into the gap.
This is what we were talking about before. Durham's going to want to finish up strong going into that second game of that doubleheader.
Even if they can't really come back in this game, if they can get a few runs here in the top of the seventh, like you said, can give them a bit of momentum heading into game two.
And that momentum is everything.
Absolutely. Ball's on the outside corner, strike one. Is Max Mockin at the plate. 0 for 2 with a couple ground outs. Ball, big curveball. Umpire say just up. 2-1 here. Breaking ball has been very effective so far for Pollard in this game. Ball's ripped foul. Right near the camera over there. Almost catching our camera down there on the right side. Everything looks to be okay.
Looks like she's laughing it off.
Yeah, it looks, counts now 2-2 here. Max Mockin. Just outside. Count moves to 3-2 here. Only one out here in the inning. Connor May, he's on deck. He's a couple base hits for the Lords. There's the curveball. On the 3-2 count by Pollard, strike three, as Malkin goes down looking. Shows the confidence that Pollard has in that breaking ball, throwing it 3-2. Now bring up Connor May. May has scored the only run of the game for the Lords. Up and in. Ball up and in there again. Count goes to 2-0. Good hitter's count now for Connor May. Looking for his third hit of the game. Ball check swing. Umpire calling it a strike anyways. Count goes to 2-1. Connor May trying to keep the Lords alive here with two outs. Ball's fouled off to the left side. Pollard now with one strike away from ending this game.
And his second straight complete game.
Yeah, he had a complete game in his last performance against Fanshawe. Looking to do the same here. Ball is fouled off once again by May, staying alive here. Here comes the 2-2 offering from Pollard. The curveball. You could see Mara thought it was over. So did Pollard. Umpire saying that was a bit low. Looked pretty good from up here. Count moves to 3-2. Regan Manley at second base. Fastball once again fouled off by May. Pollard definitely wanted that curveball. Call. Looked pretty good. Now he's got a battle here. 3-2. Aiden Ali on deck. Ball is in the dirt. Be ball four. No one moving in that Hawks bullpen. So this is Rory's game. He's got two outs here for Aiden Ali, who's 0-for-1 on the day with a walk. He walked back in the third inning. That curveball for strike one.
At this point, again, for the Lords, you're just looking for anything. They can just get anything momentum started with. Hit, walk, stolen base, whatever.
And there's a base hit there for Ali.
That's going to score a run.
Here comes Manley to the plate.
Or no.
And a strong throw by DeBanning right on Mara ends this game. Manley coming around trying to score from second on the base hit by Aiden Ali, and DeBanning ends this game with a strong throw to Mara.
Ladies and gentlemen, your player of the game is number 28, Rory Pollard.
Rory Pollard named player of the game. And Andrew, what did you think of Pollard's performance today?
Great performance today. Had a little bit of that hiccup in the third inning. Other than that, pitched strong, attacked the strike zone, got his outs. That was all she wrote.
Yeah, he's been dominant so far for the Hawks this season. Every time he goes out, he pitches an absolute amazing performance. Another complete game. His last outing as well was a complete game against Fanshawe. That one was a shutout. You mentioned in the third inning, he gave up that run. Only one run on three hits. Five strikeouts for Rory Pollard as the Hawks win 8-1 here in game one of this doubleheader here against the Durham Lords. Rory Pollard accepting his player of the game honors with a outstanding performance as the Hawks win 8-1. Game two is coming up.